10 times, Ronaldo shocked the world. Like when he went crazy on a fan that just wanted a picture. Or that time he started throwing shade on Manchester United and Erik ten Hag. But first, let's dive into when Ronaldo met his number one fan and created the most viral moment in 2023. Picture this, Ronaldo, the football legend, bumps into the craziest CR7 fan on the planet. Instantly, it became the Ronaldo clip to end all clips, hitting the top charts as one of the most viral moments of the year. Isho Speed, the Twitch sensation famous for cracking us up with his hilarious clips and having a borderline creepy obsession with Cristiano Ronaldo.
Smile for me. Why is that so attractive?
And guess what? It all led up to this epic moment when Speed finally comes face to face with his hero.
Oh my god! Oh my god, I'm sorry! Oh my god, we're not! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god, take a picture! Hey, take a picture! Bro, hey, I love you, bro, Ronaldo. I'm a big fan, bro.
Sue.
Ronaldo, look, I got you right here. Hey, wait, Sue, Ronaldo, Sue, Ronaldo, Sue, Sue, Sue. I love you, bro.
That even Ronaldo had to be like, dude, chill out, take a breather. Talk about fanboying at its finest. But Ronaldo hasn't always been happy when meeting fanboys. Sometimes it backfires. Back in the day when Ronaldo was rocking it at Manchester United for round two, he got all worked up after a 1-0 loss to Everton. So what does he do? Decides to vent his frustration on a fan. Plot twist. The fan turns out to be a 14-year-old autistic dude just wanting a selfie with his idol. Ronaldo, in his fit of rage, ends up smashing the poor kid's phone and accidentally hurting his hand. Talk about a jaw-dropping moment for the kid and his mom. The fans weren't having it, and even the cops joined the party. Ronaldo eventually comes around, says sorry to the kid, buys him a shiny new iPhone, and throws in an invite to another game for good measure. But here's the kicker. The FA, that's English football's big boss, decides to drop a charge on Ronaldo. He ended up facing a fat fine and a temporary ban from hitting the field. Almost makes me want to cry. But not as much when Ronaldo started crying on live television. Who can forget the time he sat down with Piers Morgan? When the chat took a detour to Ronaldo's old stomping ground, Manchester United, things got real. He didn't hold back, taking shots at the management and poor Erik ten Hag.
When I arrived, I thought everything will be different, you know, the technology, the infrastructures and everything. But I was surprised in a bad way, let's say in that way, because I saw everything was the same. No, of course not.
You never heard of this guy?
Nobody, and the people who I speak, nobody knew it was him. Deep inside me, I never saw him as a boss because I saw some points that I never agreed, and he stopped in the time as well, because if you're not being a coach, the next 5 years, you're gonna lost the identity of to be a coach.
Ouch, right? Imagine being in Manchester United's or Erik ten Hag's shoes. Not the best words to hear. But let's rewind a bit. Back then, Ronaldo wasn't even getting a starting spot. He was chilling on the bench, courtesy of the manager. That's when the gossip mill started churning, thinking maybe Ronaldo spilled the tea to push the club into cutting ties because he was itching to hit the road. But did you know that Ronaldo wasn't actually excited for the number 7 when he first arrived at Manchester United? So here's the deal. David Beckham, the English stud, had rocked Manchester United's number 7 jersey before Ronaldo rolled into town. Becks decided to peace out to Real Madrid in the same summer transfer window that Ronaldo landed at United. Talk about timing, right? Now that legendary number 7 shirt, previously worn by heavyweights like Brian Robson, George Best, and Eric Cantona, was just chilling there with no one to fill it. Sir Alex Ferguson, the big boss, looked at Ronaldo and was like, "Yep, you're the one for the job." But hold up, Ronaldo, still a teen back then, wasn't sure if he was up for such a massive responsibility. I mean, taking over from local hero Beckham was no small feat. After some hesitation though, and fueled by Sir Alex's confidence, Ronaldo said, "Sure, why not?" And that, my friend, is how he ended up with that iconic number 7. The rest? Well, they say it's history in the making. And when Ronaldo bounced from Man United, leaving everyone in shock, and then bam, he rolls up at Al Nassr, and the whole football world is like, what just happened? But hold up, it's not just the Saudi club's rep turning heads, it's the mind-blowing cash they're throwing at CR7. Get this, Ronaldo's contract with Al Nassr, spilled in December 2022, is rocking an insane $200 million a year for 2 seasons. Break it down, and you've got CR7 raking in $548,000 every 24 hours. Yeah, you heard right. More than $22,000 every single minute. And guess what? That makes him the top dog in the salary game, proving once again that CR7 isn't just a legend on the field. He's a money-making magician. $22,000? I guess I have to talk shit about Manchester United. Hope Al Nasser hears this. Okay, Man U is the worst f- piece of sh- and Ten Hag, he can go. I'll be waiting for your call, Al Nasser. Jokes aside, let's dive deeper into the Ronaldo leg saga, because seriously, it's like a physics-defying spectacle. So when science put his legs under the microscope, the results were mind-blowing. Imagine this, Ronaldo's hops are not just regular jumps, they're like he's auditioning for a superhero role. His vertical leap outdoes your average NBA player, and that's just one slice of the athletic pie. When this dude takes flight, he's cranking out a whopping 5G of G-force. That's 5 times the power of a cheetah hauling tail and what astronauts endure during liftoff. Yeah, wrap your head around that. Now, let's talk height. From a standstill, he's levitating a cool 44 centimeters. And with a running start, he defies gravity at 78 centimeters. For context, that's 7 centimeters more than your garden variety NBA player. It's like he's got a trampoline in those Nikes or something. So no shocker here. He's not just playing the game, he's rewriting the rulebook midair. Ronaldo's soaring to heights that make the competition look like they're stuck in glue. Leg day inspiration just hit a whole new level. But what's even more shocking is that Ronaldo and Georgina first crossed paths during a little shopping spree. These two lovebirds have been keeping the flame alive for nearly 7 years now. The whole love saga kicked off in 2016, when Ronaldo casually strolled into the Gucci store in Madrid, and there was Rodriguez holding it down. According to the 29-year-old model, it was like a rom-com moment. Love at first sight. She spilled the beans in a March interview, confessing, "When I saw him, he was so handsome, I felt embarrassed to look at him." Since then, they've been slaying the red carpet, jet-setting around the globe, and busy building their own little family. Talk about living the dream, right? A dream of mine is to actually play a 1v1 against Ronaldo himself. I think I'll take him to be fair. But guess what, Ronaldo, the football maestro, once hit the streets for some football hustle. Okay, not exactly chasing money, but in 2015, he pulled off this side-splitting stunt. Picture this, Ronaldo, incognito, strolling around casually playing ball with random folks on the street. How did he pull it off, you ask? Costume party, Ronaldo style. Now imagine the priceless expressions on people's faces when this seemingly regular dude turns out to have some mad football skills. But here's the kicker. Ronaldo decides to take off his disguise and boom! The street goes even crazier when people see it's none other than Ronaldo himself. The shock on people's faces was epic. He even gifted the ball to a little kid he was playing with. So, tell me, what would you do if you stumbled upon Ronaldo kicking it in a street football match? Guess who was tearing up the streets of Madrid in an 8.8 million pounds Bugatti Centodieci? Yep, none other than the football king himself, Cristiano Ronaldo. This beast of a car is so exclusive, there are only 10 of them on the entire planet. So, Ronaldo rolls up to a restaurant in the Spanish capital, probably making the valet guy's day, and the fans go nuts. I'm talking mobbed! People chanting his name, throwing selfie requests left and right. Meanwhile, Ronaldo's just trying to have a chill night out with his girlfriend, Georgina Rodriguez. The hypercar got its rare public moment, and I bet even Andrew Tate was like, "I can't buy that!"
Well, what color is your bagay?
Shut up, Andrew! Don't make me hit a strike with your bowling ball looking ass head. Well, there was a time where Ronaldo was nowhere near a Bugatti, and it was up to one woman to save his life. Ronaldo is all about keeping it real, never forgetting his roots and the peeps who had his back when he was hustling. So there's this lady, Edna, right? Ronaldo spilled the beans in a 2019 interview with Piers Morgan, and it's making waves again. Back in the day, CR7 was grinding it out in poverty in Madeira, Portugal. Picture this, a tiny house, sharing a room with his siblings. The struggle was real. Fast forward to when he was 12, he bolts from home to join Sporting Lisbon's youth academy, and man, that phase was tough. But here's the kicker. Ronaldo and his crew would sneak to the back door of the local McDonald's, scrounging up leftover burgers at the end of the night. Edna and a couple of other folks were the real MVPs, always hooking them up. From gravity-defying goals to heart-stopping skills, Ronaldo has given us more wow moments than we can count. Keep enjoying the game and see you on the pitch. Want to see more videos like this? Maybe one where we show you shocking moments in football. Click the video to watch it. You won't regret it.